Megan holds an undergraduate degree at Miami University and a PhD in chemistry from Penn State. She is currently an assistant professor at the University of Pennsylvania. Since Megan's nominators are scientists, she is distinguished among the group here tonight for having the longest, most technical letters of support, which also contained a number of scientific words that few could pronounce. I believe one letter even included an equation or two. What is clear from the nominations is that Megan's research in chemical biology and mechanistic biochemistry is ahead of its time and transformative. Her work is advancing the development of new drugs for Alzheimer's disease, among other life-saving discoveries. In addition, her professors noted that she has proven that she can inspire other young scientists to immediate research success and lifetime commitments to science. Congratulations, Megan.
So, wow, thank you so much. It's so great to be back at Penn State, and it's such an incredible honor to be among so many, this select group of inspiring and really accomplished people. So I'd like to thank the Alumni Association, Dean Kavanagh, the Eberly College of Science, and the Department of Chemistry for this prestigious award. So, when thinking about what I wanted to say today and when thinking about my time at Penn State and what it meant to me, there really are no words to describe the impact of the education that I received here, the mentorship that I rely on to this day, and in fact, just minutes ago, talking to my PhD advisor still, and the friendships that only grew stronger with each opportunity. And so in addition to my PhD education here, I was fortunate to share my time at Penn State with my sister when she received her undergraduate degree in economics. And it really made Penn State become a big part of my family. And so during my 16-year journey, pursuing science at different research institutions from coast to coast, it really was the superstar bioinorganic faculty in the chemistry department that gave me the inspiration that I needed to really dig deep within myself to overcome what felt like at times very impossible challenges. And when I look back on the process, what I realize about myself is that I thrive on the pressure and the challenges and that is exciting to me. And Penn State and everything that I did here and what I learned here really allowed me to, think big, be creative, be innovative, and trust myself in doing so through that whole process. I'm especially grateful to Marty Bollinger and Carsten Krebs who saw and still see in me what I didn't know was there. And that was the confidence to overcome obstacles in all of their forms, and for encouraging me to always remember that in the end, the most important thing is the science. That's what matters. So now, the coolest part about what I'm doing now is that Penn State provided me a model that I want to emulate so that I can provide my new research group with the same inspiration, the same rigorous training, so that they may reach their potential and accomplish their goals as I have done mine and still continue to do. And so it's because of the strong support of my mentors that really helped me accomplish this dream and follow in their footsteps to become a chemistry professor. And so I need to thank my supportive colleagues and my dear friend, Shen Zhang, for nominating me for this prestigious award, and Don Ebs for making this all happen. And lastly, I thank my family, and my biggest supporter of all, my incredible husband, who has been dedicated to me and to this journey since the very beginning. So thank you.